This is Professor Rogers. This presentation is an introduction to key concepts in inferential statistics. Inference is different from description and occurs with bivariate and multivariate analysis. With inference, we claim to know about how two variables may be associated. We cannot make these kinds of inferences with descriptive statistics. The concepts we need to understand are direction, magnitude, statistical significance, and performance of the model. Note that with statistical significance, we also get into hypothesis testing. Not every statistical technique will have all four of these characteristics, but we look for them when they are available. Direction has to do with how the variables move together. We speak of direction as positive or negative. A relationship is said to be positive when the independent and dependent variables increase together. Here we see that as the x value increases, the y value also increases. By contrast, a relationship is said to be negative when the independent and dependent variables move in opposite directions. Here we see the x value increasing as the y value decreases. This relationship is also sometimes called an inverse relationship. For certain statistics, we do not express direction as positive or negative, but we use likelihoods. The concepts are analogous. A positive relationship is analogous to an increase in the likelihood of the event occurring, and a negative relationship is analogous to a decrease in the likelihood of the event occurring. Magnitude has to do with the size or strength of the relationship. This concept is now also sometimes referred to as statistical power or effect size. Sometimes we use a specific number to describe the magnitude. We have to learn these situations on a statistic-by-statistic basis. Other times we discuss magnitude using terms like strong, moderate, weak, or non-existent. Several statistics are standardized so that the magnitude varies between 0 and 1. When this occurs, there are standard conventions for interpreting the size of the magnitude. A relationship is said to be non-existent or virtually non-existent if the magnitude is less than 0.10, weak if the magnitude is between 0.10 and 0.29, moderate if it is between 0.30 and 0.49, strong if it is between 0.50 and 0.69, and very strong if it is 0.70 or above. One needs to know the data, though, because there may be situations in which the standard convention does not apply. Statistical significance is linked to the notions of hypothesis testing and p-values. You may have often heard that a finding is statistically significant if the p-value is less than 0.05. I explain what this means. We usually use a 95% confidence interval to establish significance. Confidence intervals are discussed in a different video. 0.05 refers to the area under the curve outside the 95% confidence interval. Here we see the area outside the confidence interval in a two-tailed distribution. Each tail of the distribution has 2.5% of the points in it, or collectively 5% of the points. We usually refer to the area as a proportion, where 1 equals the total area under a curve. As a result, our 5% is often referred to as a proportion of 0.05. Our concern is where is the value of 0. Elsewhere, we learned that due to sampling, we never know the true population mean, and we use the confidence interval as a hedge. This concern leads us to hypothesis testing. Our concern is whether we should accept or reject the null hypothesis. When we use the term hypothesis here, we do not mean the hypothesis that is derived from our research question. The other use of the term hypothesis refers to a particular type of statistical test. The null hypothesis is that 0 falls within the confidence interval, and therefore there is no relationship. If 0 is within the confidence interval, we accept the null hypothesis. If 0 is outside the confidence interval, we reject the null hypothesis. The alternative hypothesis is a statement that a significant relationship may be present. You will find that there are differences among researchers as to whether the alternative hypothesis is needed. I myself think the alternative hypothesis is redundant, but some of you may be in programs that use an alternative hypothesis. Both approaches are accepted as legitimate, and you should use the approach conventional in your area of study. Our final concern is the performance of the model. The idea of a model is endemic to multivariate statistics. When we develop equations with more than one independent or control variable, we not only assess the results for individual variables, but also for all the variables as a whole. We have statistics built around the explanatory power of these models. Terms like goodness of fit or classification algorithm are often used in discussing how well the model works. A natural question is whether one measure is more important than others. This assumption is a common mistake of students and professional researchers alike. The tendency is to focus on only one number in making inferences, and the number often chosen is p-value conveying statistical significance. People believe that if they have statistical significance, nothing else matters. However, this belief is not warranted and can lead to a misinterpretation of the results. In fact, all are important. Here are some real scenarios that I have seen over the course of many years of data analysis. A relationship can be statistically significant, but the effect so small that it is meaningless. This situation often occurs with very large samples. A relationship might not be statistically significant, yet be very large. This situation often occurs with small samples. A group of variables may be individually significant, but the entire model might not explain much. A group of variables might not be significant, but their combined effect may result in an entire model that is significant. In the presentation, we introduced four ideas key to inferential statistics. We learned about direction, magnitude, statistical significance, and performance of the model. We will have plenty of opportunities to see these ideas applied at the bivariate and multivariate levels.